It won't go away. I've got that feeling rushing through my body. I know that it is here to stay. It's like you're my...
Hey guys, it's me, and today we are going to go through my empties. I have them everywhere because every time I ran out of something, I would put it aside thinking, I need to add this to my empties, and then I never got them together. It's just, ever since we've been living here, I just have not been organized, and it's no one's fault but my own. I have been here long enough that I should have done that, but it was just one of those things that I did not do well. Let's just say that. I did have most of them on my shelf in my closet. The reason I didn't use that basket that I usually do is because I had all of my back to Mac in that basket. Okay, so you don't need to hear all about all that. So let's, speaking of Mac, I just opened a new one of these this morning. This is the Mac brush cleaner. Like I said, it's like I can hear what people are gonna say. It has one, Ulta has one, Real Techniques has one, Cinema Secrets. I don't like any of those. I like this because I put out, before I even do my makeup, I put out a little piece of napkin, I sprinkle this around, and I clean each brush as I use it. If you do that with the Cinema Secrets, it has so much alcohol in it, it evaporates off of the napkin. And I don't like the smell. It leaves that scent in my brushes. Okay, this is something that I feel like I have gotten across to you, but just in case you're new, this is a candle that I got from Walmart. Good, and it is the Relax Lavender Jasmine Chamomile Coconut Wax Blend. One of you told me that you were allergic to soy and that you can't even burn soy candles. And I have an interesting little story. I tried a new skincare, this was weeks ago, probably a month ago. It's a cleanser that had peppermint in it. Peppermint oil, and it's a really high-end cleanser. And I would use the cleanser, like, I didn't put it on my face. What would I do? My usual wipe, I would put a little bit of the cleanser on my washcloth, and I would cleanse all around, not going over my eyes. But then what I would do, which is classic of me, is I rinse the washcloth out, where in my mind the soap's gone, but it isn't. And then I really go around my eyes and I get out all the residue of the mascara and everything. Come to find out, I am allergic to peppermint oil. And my eyes swelled up almost shut. And I mean, it did not go away for days. And so I had a hard time believing that, actually. So when I looked up allergic to peppermint oil, I came across all of these people, and this is why I want to tell you this, that were putting peppermint oil or a mixture of peppermint oil in their diffusers. And they would do that at night, and then they were suffering all of these illnesses. I mean, rashes, their eyes swelling, all of these things. And they were going through, I mean, going to doctor, to doctor, to doctor, trying to find out what it was, and come to find out it was the oils in their diffusers. It doesn't have to be peppermint. It can be anything you can be allergic to. So that's why I just wanted to throw that out there. So that's, I thought about you who told me that you couldn't burn soy candles, and I just think that's very interesting. The Colleen Rothschild cotton squares, just luxurious. They're kind of like the Shiseido, but they're bigger. And I'm not even a cheap person, but I usually will cut one in half to use my toner. I use the matcha toner from her, and they're great. They're smooth, silky, luxurious. This is the Rhodial Velvet Cream. This is what's in that combo that I just got through promoting my edit. And so many of you got that and you sent me messages and you love it, and thank you so much. That makes me feel so good. And this is one of my empties. You can see I got every last bit of it. This is a very, if you got it, you'll know what I mean. It's like, I can't even say it's hard. It's not whippy. It's very solid. What else is, there's something else that's like that I use every once in a while. I think maybe the Colleen Rothschild Recovery Cream. It's almost like Noxzema texture, if I can even remember what that feels like. But you kind of have to break into it and you'll get a piece of it out. And it'll have like jagged edges where it's just kind of like a clump of it. But then when you rub it in your skin, it is so moisturizing, soothing. It feels so wholesome. You know what I mean? It just feels like it's feeding your skin. I love it. So if you got it, I hope you love it too. I think it's a great night cream. I use it sometimes in the morning. I especially use it if I feel like my skin is irritated. Okay, this is the Trish McAvoy Instant Solutions Triangle Light Eye Mask. I left this in here, not that I have used, I think I got this as a sample, but I just wanted to remind you, you know, a lot of the brands that we hear about over and over and over again are just, they're popular. They've become popular on YouTube. And a lot of times they send out good PR. Trish McAvoy doesn't do that. But I have had her message me directly after I was talking about some of her products. She is a good person. She, if you will just watch some of her videos, she is so real. And her products are really good. And even myself, I don't use them as much as I should because they're not on your mind. So I just wanted to say she has really good products, especially her eyeshadows. I love that planner. You know, those during the Nordstrom sale, they'll usually have a planner. Maybe I'll get that this year so we can just look at it together. I just don't want you to forget about her stuff. Okay, this is the Hot Spring Spa Body Wash and Foam Bath from Bath & Body Works. I tend to like either the beachy scents, and I really love the spa and the men's scents. Okay, this is another cream that I love with all of my heart. It is the City Beauty Multi-Action Sculpting Cream. Now, I do love when you guys told me about the Rhodial Sculpting Gel, I started using it. And it's not a gel like, you know, I can't think of anything. It's not like aloe gel or something like that, but it's not as creamy as this. So if you are someone with, I would say, my skin is normal to oily. If you have normal to dry, I would say this. Maybe if you have oily skin, that would be better. It's a little bit lighter. I don't know. Or if some people say when they use this that it peels up on them and they can't put their makeup over it. I don't know why that never happens to me. I do know that I let it settle for a good probably 10 or 15 minutes before I start putting makeup on. So, and I use a beauty blender. So maybe that helps, but I love this stuff. I never want to be without it. I love it. This I just told you about the other day. Look at this little baby. I think I must have gotten this in I think it was a Nordstrom order I got this in. That is the cutest little thing. So, you know, I just bought a big box or a big can of that. This, I just got through burning. Oh my goodness, I need to order the biggest one they have. This is the candle that I have told you about for months and months. It's the Ergo Rosemary. To me, it does not smell like rosemary. Like, it doesn't smell like fresh rosemary, but it does smell spa-like. And I was, you know, experimenting with candles, going through a bunch of different ones, and I needed to smell that home. This smells like home to me. So we burn it and we all loved it so much, you know, the John and the kids and I. So I think this is just like my signature candle, and I can't wait when we get in our new home to have these everywhere and have my house smelling like this. And if you don't know the story, the reason I even discovered this candle is because when I was on a girls' trip, we met with Kendra Scott at a local restaurant. I went to the bathroom, there was a candle burning, and I just loved it. I mean, I just loved the way it made me feel and the way it smelled. And so you know what? It's more than that. I think when we walked in the restaurant, I complimented the waitress on the way it smelled, and she said it's a candle burning in the bathroom, and it just smells that good, because the bathroom was at the front. And I remember looking at it and taking a picture in the bathroom, and that's how it all started. And that was probably 2019 or 18, probably 19. So love it, love it. And you can see how clean it burns. Colleen Rothschild Quench and Shine Restorative Shampoo I've told you, I feel like I've got a cat hair or something. Hold on. Can't find anything, but I feel like I've got like a cat hair or something like right here. My lipstick's probably gonna be all messed up now in my lip liner. Okay, so here we go back. Quench and Shine Restorative Shampoo from Colleen. I used this last night with her restorative conditioning balm, or what does she call it? The mask. And it is just my stay in the shower shampoo. When I read the book by the Kando, the art, what was it? The Tidiness. You guys know that book I was talking about. I'll put it down below. I loved what she said about keeping your shower tidy and not having all of your stuff in there. She said what she does is she keeps all of her shampoos and everything for the shower underneath her sink. And then when you go to get in the shower, you decide what you're going to use and you take it to the shower and then you put it up. Well, that I don't do that with everything, but what I do is this and the mask stays in the shower, and my bottle of Renew from Monet, those stay in the shower. But then when I want to alternate, I will bring something else in the shower, just like the Pureology Hydrate. I might use it, last time I used it twice, and then I'll probably rotate to something else and use these kind of in between. So that's kind of weird, isn't it? But that's just what I do. This is, I mainly left this in here just to kind of give you an update. This is the H2 Ocean salt spray that I have had to spray my ears with. So I got, if you haven't been here, I got these two second piercings and this, which is the Doth. I got these done, how many months ago would you say? Probably, I don't know, probably 2 or 3 months ago, and everything is fine. This one, I never even, these didn't bother me at all. One time, this one got inflamed a little bit, and I had to, you know, just wait it out. This one kind of comes and goes. Like right now, it isn't really sore, but I mean, it isn't, I can tell it's not like all the way healed. But this is what I spray, and I was very, very religious about this. I did it every morning and every night. I would just put my hair up, tuck it behind my ear, spray the heck out of it. I would hold a washcloth up to it, and that's what I did. Okay, this is a little blast from the past. It's the Maison Louise Marie No. 4 Bois de Balancourt, one of my favorite fragrances. I don't know where it is. I packed up my fragrances, and it's funny because we've been deciding who we're gonna get to help move us. And I told John, I said, really? You know, all that complaining I did, remember how freaked out I was after they moved us? You guys helped me realize that's just the way it is. It wasn't, you know, particularly those movers that threw my stuff around and packed up the crazy stuff. It was just the nature of the move. You know, it's just the nature of the business. So I told John, I said, go ahead and get the same ones. Now I know I will do better. So somewhere I packed up my fragrances and they got put somewhere and I haven't seen them. But we kind of just moved into this house and stuck everything in the garage and didn't mess with it. So I'm sure we're going to find a lot of stuff when we move again. So I love that fragrance, but I had this, which was the body lotion. I used it up while we lived here and I love it. It smells so good. It is the most... Ooh, I have some left in here. Okay, are you like this? I can't put on lotion very well with my ring. I can with my wedding ring, but not with my... Okay, it's kind of thick. It's not usually this thick. Ugh, the smell. Okay. How do I describe this fabulous... It's feminine. It's bright without being citrusy or too floral. It's still smooth. And it's just happy. And I'll be honest with you, my mom wears this too. I got it for her. So, you know, anything that reminds you of your mom or someone you love, it probably brings back great memories. But it's just, ooh, I love it. I love it. So anyway, I don't even know if it's still available, but if it is, I'll put it down below. Okay, this, I know I've shown you a million times, but my favorite toothpaste. I just love it. I love it. I do alternate. I alternate between the one that Melody sent me, which is the Thieves. I can't remember. It's the people that sell the oils and stuff. I use that one. And then I like a Crest whitening one. I alternate with those, but this is my go-to. This is kind of like, you know, I have shampoos that stay in the shower. This would be a toothpaste that would stay always in the drawer. Okay, this is something I put in here because I did not like it at all, and it's the Whey body cream. I don't know if it has a particular scent, like if there's different ones, but this, I don't know what it was. I think Brooke used it too and didn't like it. If I had to say right off the bat what it smells like, it's the original Vaseline lotion, but it just wasn't something, like, I didn't even want to use it again. So, just, sorry, Jen. This, I actually have another one that's like to hear. This is also the City Beauty. This is a City Lips Clear. I never want to be without it. I'm not saying that I don't use other things. I usually put this on after I brush my teeth. After I brush my teeth, both at night and in the morning. Now, sometimes I will need some more before I go to bed. And I've got like some other stuff that I just keep on the nightstand. I think it's the Laneige. I will put that on. But this is just my go-to. I think it does plump. The Clear and the San Diego are my go-tos. And I love them. Love them. I've got two bottles of this. The Lumify drops. I really think they help. Especially, I mean, if you're not doing videos, you might not care. But I will tell you this. Tammy and I have talked about this, about the things that we would have never noticed or would have never bothered us if we didn't have to watch ourselves doing video. Because, you know, these, sometimes my videos are an hour long. I mean, imagine all the times that I change my clothes and I'm like walking around with no clothes on. It's not pretty sometimes. I mean, you see some things, I mean, that are just kind of can be upsetting. You see yourself bending over, putting your pants on. I mean, it is just hilarious. So, a lot of times you don't notice. Like, I didn't notice how bloodshot my eyes were. And so, even if you're not doing videos, wouldn't it be great to have nice, pretty white eyes? Or maybe you don't you wouldn't realize that your teeth need whitening or something. So, it's not always a bad thing that I notice these, you know? And so, anyway. I always like to go off on little tangents, but that's how I feel about that. Rhodial jelly eye patches. I had this box in my little side thing the other night, and I wanted to put these on, and it was empty. I had used the last one, not knowing, and it was empty. And I have one in my kit, but I wanted to keep it to show you guys. So I will be getting some more of these. I love them. These and the Wander Gold Baggage Claim or whatever. They are my favorite eye mask. Favorite. The last thing, something I have used for years and years. My mom likes this too. It is the Kendra Blow Dry Spray. Advanced Dry Thermal Protection. My new love is that In Common Magic Mist. I have used it every night since I got it. Every night. No matter what. I don't even use anything else. Last night, I knew it was, we have just had like the rainiest couple of weeks, and it's not going to get any better anytime soon. So let's see when my next sunshiny day may be. Friday. So luckily there has been like some sporadic sunshine that I've been able to get out in to help me a little bit. But last night when I was drying my hair, I'm craving wanting to curl it or do something, but I just know I don't want to do that damage if it's going to be humid and raining outside. So all I used last night was the Kerastase oil on the ends and that mist. And then I blow dry it with my round brush. And, you know, it's, see how smooth it is? I mean, it's not perfect. Plus, I slept with it down, and you can see, like, you can try all you want, but that natural is going to come back sometimes. But, you know I'm probably going to get rained on today. The other day, how long have I been talking? The other day, I went to Walmart. I think it was, you'll hear about it in my Walmart video. I went to Walmart, and I was checking out. And the cashier said, "Is that rain?" It was raining so hard, it sounded like horses, like running across the roof. Like, that's how hard it was raining. So, I pushed my buggy up, and I had my Fendi the Black Peekaboo, and I did not want to get that thing wet, and I had like a buggy full of groceries, and wet groceries are gross, and I always park far away because I don't want my car getting dinged, and I feel like it's just extra time out in the fresh air, extra exercise. So I had parked way out. So I'm standing there, and we stood there so long. I got to know the greeter. He's from Buffalo, New York. Then he moved to Mississippi. Then he moved here. There was another girl. She was from, her accent was so much more southern than mine. And I said, "Are you from here?" And she said, "Yeah." And I was thinking, Then she said she was from, I can't even remember, Sampson County or something, which is another county that's in, and their southern accent is just a little different and stronger. Anyway, stood there so long, I got to know everyone. Finally, it starts, still raining, but not pouring down. So I'm like, okay, I'm going for it. I condense my bags, get a bag, and I put a grocery bag or just like a Walmart bag over my Fendi bag, trying to keep as much water off of it as possible. Get to my car, and my car is the type that when you walk up to it with the keys, it's supposed to unlock. And it did. It unlocked, so I opened the hatch, and right when I think it was right before I got to it, pouring down. I mean, that kind of rain where the drops feel like they're this big. I mean, just buckets coming down. So I'm like kind of halfway hiding underneath the top. It's not even the whole hatch because mine, the bottom is separate from the top. So it only opens like that. And you kind of just put the groceries over the bottom. You have to push another bottom for it to come down. And so the whole time, my back, butt, pants, they are soaking wet. So then I pushed a button, I shut it down, I run around to the thing, and it won't. My keys are in my purse, and my driver door is not opening. I guess it's just not strong enough to get through. So I have to go back, run around, open that again with my butt and everything out in the rain, dig through my purse, get my keys, and then go back. I was so drenched, you guys. When I got home, my bra was soaked. My pants were soaked. I was soaking wet. So it has been raining. I don't even know what the point of my story was, but that taught me a lesson. When you know it might rain, bring your umbrella in. So I got on one of my Walmart dresses. When I was downstairs putting on my jewelry, John said, "You look pretty today." And then he said again, "You look pretty. I love that dress." And I said, "It's one of my Walmart dresses." So, I mean, there you go. I just think they have some good stuff. So anyway, I'll be right back. So you guys probably remember the dress. It wasn't too long ago. And I cannot even remember if it still comes in other colors. But I love this because it's so, I mean, you can't beat tan, black, and white. And then because I know it's going to rain today, I just have on my flip-flops. And this is a funny little story. Yesterday I went to get my toenails done. I usually like to go about once a week. It's just like a treat. I get a lot of my Instagram work done when I'm there. And it's a way to, I don't know, I usually get a fancy one. I tip good. It's just all in all, I think it's a good thing. And so I sat down, and you know how they always tell you pick a color? Well, I told her right from the beginning, I just want black. And you know, she looked at me like I was crazy, but I love the look of black toes or Linkin Park After Dark with a tan. I just think of like Turks and Caicos or something. I just think of like just something so chic. You know, it was the girl that I don't normally have, but she did a great job. And I get out in the sunlight and look, I think they're either dark blue or dark purple. I don't know, but I still like them, but they are not black. So when they tell you to pick a color, you better go pick your color. I've got on the Erin Fader. Is it Erin Fader Wolf Ring? I think that's it. I'll link it below. I love this ring. Jenny Bird necklaces, my triple hoops. I keep going back to these, and my Rolex watch and the same nail polish. So I hope you guys have a wonderful Monday. Today's Sunday, but I'm going to post this on Monday, and I will see you on Wednesday. I can't wait. See you then. Bye-bye.